and welcome to another edition of Ask Excite. I'm Tim Bush, now with Expert Cytometry, and today's question comes from Vicky. And Vicky asks, how do you set voltages on your instrument? That's a great question, Vicky, and there's a lot of different ways to do that. In the old days, back when we had the analog systems, we were taught to put our unstained sample in the first decade, in the lower left quadrant. So all the negative cells were on scale, but in that first quadrant. With the advent of the digital instruments like we have now, we really can take advantage of the fact that it's easy for us to determine the optimal voltage. And we do that in a variety of different ways. My favorite method is the peak 2 method, where we run a dim particle, the second peak of the Spherotech 8-peak beadset, over a voltage range and plot the coefficient of variance of that versus the voltage. As the voltage comes up, the CV goes down, and it's going to reach a point where it hits a minimum, and then the curve levels off. At that inflection point, the PMT is its most sensitive, using our beads, of course. And so that's a good starting voltage. During panel development, if I'm going to be using a panel for a long time, I'm going to go through a second step called voltration, where I will stain my cells with a tighter concentration of antibody. And I do the same thing. I run my cells from that optimal voltage up to see if I can improve the signal. And I use the staining index to calculate that signal. And if I can find a better signal separation, then I'm going to use that voltage. Why do you do this? Why does this work? Because our beads, or the hard-dyed beads, don't necessarily reflect the fluorochromes that we're using. Brilliant violets, brilliant UVs, quantum dots, and things of that nature are not reflected in our current bead set. So therefore, by further optimizing it, we can get a better signal. And once we've done that, those are the voltages I'm going to use, and I'm going to maintain those and monitor those using a quality control metric, such as the sixth peak of the Spherotech bead set or some other variant. So thanks for your question. And remember, if you have more questions, go to getflowtraining.com to get more information, or send me an email here at askexcite@expertcytometry.com. Thanks again for another Ask Excite. Until next time, stay tuned to hear for all your best practices of flow cytometry with me, Tim, and Team Excite.